If someone came to your father
or your mother
and speak, you know, badly with her, are you going to watch him just washing? Are you going to that? We have a God. The God here has a
period. As a Muslim, what did you do? What were you instructed to do if somebody's insulting you? You were instructed to walk away.
No, you're telling me,
I understand. I'm also a Muslim myself. We are instructed to walk away. What you're doing now is not guilty.
Jordan, spit us on facts. Move out my way then.
We live in a country where that's allowed. In the speaker's corner, she's allowed to do that.
So we
walk away. Yeah. We walk away and we keep our composure. Yeah?
Okay, no problem.
Because all these cameras, these guys are going to put this out. They look how aggressive Muslims are.
Let me explain what's
going on.
Can I ask you a question?
Go on.
You know, the God, he has a priority before our fathers and mothers, okay?
Of course.
Okay? If someone now, I'm talking about the logic, you know, leave the rules, you know, about the logic. If someone come to your father or your mother and insult them, you know, or abuse them, are you going to say, we have some rules in this country?
It's your choice to come
protect
to
us, protect
it's
them.
It's your choice to come to Speaker's Corner. If somebody's going to insult my mum, I won't go near them. Yeah? I will stay away from them. And you have the option as well. I don't like what I see. I'm offended. But as Muslims, we have to control our anger. We have to control ourselves. And we have to think better. Tattooing is a waste of space, 100%. But we have to be Muslim. And we have to just keep our character.
Are you Muslim?
I am Muslim.
Sorry?
I understand his offence, but I'm saying that his reactions and his anger needs to be controlled.
You have to divide people.
So the best thing is walk away and let them just not be on their own. No division then after that.
What does it say in the Quran about mocking? You walk away.
So truth is where you're born. So if I'm born here, I can't be Muslim.
No, nothing to do with that. Read the bloody book and see the nastiness of it.
Have you read the Quran?
Oh, I tried to.
You haven't even read
it's
it.
Horrible.
So you're telling me you haven't even read the Quran?
I've read bits of it. I've read enough to see.
What's your favourite surah?
They're all rubbish. They're incorrect theologically. They're rubbish. Look. There is no.
See, what's interesting is you probably actually have no knowledge of Islam. Right, tell me.
Knowledge.
Tell me why I shouldn't be Muslim. Tell me what was so wrong about what I embrace, other than the fact that you see it as some foreign religion.
Listen, if you look at that, don't look at this.
Tell me, I want to know.
Because you look like you've got some brain cells working there.
So because I'm white.
No, because you work
for race.
No, but that's what it is.
So why do I look intelligent? Why do I look intelligent?
Why do I look more intelligent than... Why do I look more intelligent than this man?
Sorry? So you look intelligent. You're here trying to defuse a situation that's potentially aggressive. Yeah, that would place you as someone with a bit of sense, no?
That's what a Muslim does, and you may not see that. You may not see that.
That's what a Jew does.
I can explain. I can explain if you let me answer.
Don't bring the white stuff into it. I'll start bringing race.
Okay, well, let me hear. Let me hear why this man, I've been told that I should have brains and I shouldn't be Muslim. So I want to know why. The only thing I can think of
I'm allowed to
make comments too.
Don't reference the white thing.
I'll do what I want. Thank you.
Obviously.
Okay, well, let's go to the most absurd surah. The one about Solomon and the talking ants. Okay? Are you saying that this actually happened?